So today we are going to be talking about nothing. Nada. Zero. The artist formerly known as nothing. What does zero mean in a data set? What does null mean in a data set? Null is a very tricky thing. So in this video, we are going to be talking about what are the pitfalls that could come about if you are using a null value, as well as some strategies to get around it. So with that, let's go check it out. What does nothing mean? Well, in the context of data, nothing has to be pretty explicit because if something is just missing or it has a null value, which is what you would see in the code, you have to understand what does it mean and what can you do with it? In many ways, if you have a null value, can really mess up your code. It can throw a lot of errors. And in Java, it's kind of an accident that it's there to begin with, but it does have a pointer to something else that it is talking about. Yeah, sort of like that. But there, that's cuter. That's my dog. He's also a pointer. So when you are looking at null, you have to determine what does it mean, what you're going to do with it, and when is it allowed? So in code, you do have to have mandatory information, or in a database, you have to have mandatory fields, or you at least should have mandatory fields. What is required versus what is nice to have? So if a null value is in something like a date, if you're dealing with search engines, if you're looking at the date, that's currency. Do you want to serve something up that's 30 years old? Probably not. So having a null value in a date field is pretty bad. Well, what if a date value has the month, the day, but not the year? Well, you can't tell what year it is. The rest of it doesn't matter. Now, if you have the month and the year, that's usually a little bit better. If you have the day and the year, that doesn't help you because then you have 12 different options. But what about historical information or information from other areas? Not all cultures have month, day, year. What about historical dates, for instance? You might have something that was written in the year of the cherry blossom. True fact. That is a date in some of the data that I have worked with. What do you do with it? What do you do if parts of a field are missing in this instance? Well, let's take some examples right here. Now, these are all examples from a research study that is being conducted with Edinburgh University and our Juan Cicada, who has been on this channel before at data.world, and they are doing a survey regarding null values and trying to improve it, maybe making some standards around it. So if you are interested in that, I'm going to put the link down below to the survey and to the study. If you want to go and check that out, I think that would be much appreciated. So let's take this example over here. So let's say you have three customers. Each of those customers has a customer ID, a surname, and a given name. Surname is the last name, and given name is a first name. So let's say you have that information. Well, what if you don't have all the components of that information? So if you only have a first name or if you only have a last name, typically you will still always have a customer ID because that's usually something your system is generating. Now, let's say this customer information also has some purchase order information. So if in your purchase order table, you have the purchase order number, the customer ID, because you need to know which customer bought those things, and you have price and you have tax. Well, what if the price is null? What if the tax is null? What if the tax is zero? These are all very bad for doing queries because if you're trying to find, with this example, the total amount of money one customer has spent on their purchase, if you have two lines like this, where there's one line that has actual information, another line that has a null value and a zero value, and then another line that has null and null. Okay, so if we're looking at this, the null and the zero are different values in the same field. So that tells me that zero and null are not the same thing. Okay, that helps when I'm making my query. But if null is a missing value or a value that I don't know, I can't construct the query well. So if I did this query and I was looking for the total purchase amount that the customer has, I wouldn't get very good results. In that example, if I had the value zero, especially when it's coming to price, that might mean that the price was zero. That's legitimate. Zero can actually be a value. But if I'm looking at something like a date, zero is not necessarily a value. So the unfortunate thing is, in code, null actually can be a value. So people do a lot of crazy things to get around a null value. Essentially what it means is we always are going to have some kind of missing information. It's up to you. What are you going to do about it? You can't just let it run amok. You have to have some kind of standardization on when null is appropriate and when it is used, how others can quickly determine what it means so that their queries are effective. All right, so here are your options with null. You could just not use null at all. If you just delete the whole row of data and you say, my rule is that only complete data is allowed in my database. Okay, but you also could be missing a lot of things in your ultimate query and database because there are a lot of data sets that are going to have some kind of missing value. And sometimes situationally, it is a necessity. So the artist formerly known as Prince did not have a last name. So what do you do with that? Is his last name null? Is his last name zero? Do you just use his original name? Because that's not actually accurate. So this is where you really do have to put some kind of rules in place, some kind of governance in place so that people know what to do with null in your individual systems. You could use a safe alternate. So that could be putting NA, that could be using zero for a null value. But there again, you have to be very careful because zero can be a legitimate value in certain circumstances. So if you are putting something in that's an alternate to imply a null value, then you just have to be very careful with that because again, zero is a real number. And in some cases, null can actually be a legitimate value. It really depends on what information you're looking at. For instance, Prince could have a null value for his last name. Zero wouldn't make sense in that situation. And again, with price, zero is a legitimate price. So you do have to be very careful with what kind of information you're using with this. Another tactic that I am just not a fan of in any way, shape, or form is you make the value up. Oh, it's so cringy. So some people think that you can take the mean, median, or mode of the information and you can use that for your null value instead of using a null. Again, if there are certain situations for this that make sense, you know, by all means, do what makes sense. But I have a hard time finding what situation you might be in where you would want to use a made-up value in your data. It does happen. So let's talk about date again. So with date, the year of the cherry blossoms. Well, maybe I know cherry blossoms equates to April, and then I know that the date was in the 1900s, but I don't know the day. Okay, well maybe I can just say it is the first of the month because I don't know. I really caution making up some of those numbers because you need to be very good about documenting when those numbers were made up, what the rules were when they were made up, because if you don't do that, people might not realize that it's not the actual value. So be very careful when you're doing that. So let's switch over to some tactics that I like a little bit more. You can clearly state which fields are mandatory. That means if you are dealing with customer data, maybe you need just the customer ID, customer's last name, and what they purchased, the ID for what they purchased. If those are the only mandatory fields, other fields can have a null value. And again, null is not necessarily something you cannot put into code. There are ways to go about doing that. But just make sure that none of those null values are in the very important fields that you are looking at. So what that means is your core data set is going to be solid. It's not going to have null in it. But anything else that's not really a core value to you might have null in it. The other thing is that it's more along the lines of making up the data, but in a smart way. And so this one is looking at a predictive field. So I would say putting this in a different field. So if you are dealing with date, again, for that example, if you are trying to predict the date that this happened, you can have this in a separate field. So you wouldn't have it in the date field. You would have it in a separate field called predictive date. And then that predictive date field, everybody would know, okay, this isn't the exact date. This is the prediction that we made. Now, you could also do that with the made up version, but the made up version is still going to have unknown logic as to why someone picked the number that they did, because the mean, median, mode is always going to be changing because the data set is always changing. So keep that in mind. When you're doing predictive analytics, you can at least put in, I used this date to this date, or something that can actually dictate why that prediction was made. And usually using predictive analytics will give you a much better result in that field as well. Another one is you have different environments within code and within databases. So if you have records that are incomplete, you can leave those in the dev environment and don't push them up into production. You have records that are not complete and you want to not add more noise into your production environment, leave them in the dev environment. Don't put them into production environment, or leave them in the raw data. If you're using an S3 bucket or something else, just leave them there. Make a note which ones, right, are not getting picked up in your logs, but don't add them to your data set if that's what you're looking at. So this is a little different from deleting the field or the record that has a null value in it, but it is a better way of not polluting your data source with a lot of null values that you cannot control. And it also allows you to pick away at that dev environment. So it's almost like creating a queue of records that you want to enhance or use predictive modeling on, or perhaps go back to whoever is generating those records and get better data from them. All right, so that was my quick take on null values. There are resources down below to go and check out some more on how these are used in different code bases. And my final word on it is it all depends on what your use case is. Null does not equate to evil. And as long as you know what it's being used for and it is being used in a controlled manner, I think it's okay. But you have to know that those boundaries are in place so that it doesn't get away from you and it degrades your data set and your databases. All right, so with that, I want to thank you very much, and I'll catch you next time.